When the replacement string starts with backslash equal to, it will be treated as a Vim expression. Let us see a few examples. Suppose you want to append the current date. So let us match a line containing date and colon, and let us set it to the start of the match. In replacement, we'll start with backslash equal to so that we can provide an expression. And then we can call a Vim function called strftime, and we can provide the date format we need. So year, month, and date. So result of this function will be appended to this string. So you can see the current date has been added. Next, let us see how to perform arithmetic operation on numbers that are matched. Suppose you want to multiply these numbers by 2. So we can match digit characters. In the replacement string, we'll use a function called submatch. So this is like back references. 0 gives the entire matched portion. If there are capture groups, then you can use corresponding numbers. So now we have the matched number, and we can multiply this by 2 and use the G flag as well. So these numbers should get multiplied by 2. You can see 4 becomes 8 and 10 becomes 20. A similar example, suppose our input is an arithmetic expression and we want to append the result of this expression. So let us capture the input arithmetic expression and let us set the start of the match. In the replacement, first we need to add space equal to space. This is just for readability purpose. So we are adding equal to. So this is just a normal string, and then we need to concatenate this with the result of this arithmetic expression. So we'll call the eval function and we'll pass the contents of this capture group. So we should get space equal to space and the result of this arithmetic expression. Next, let us see how to perform a substitution operation on a matched portion. So suppose this is our input line and we want to affect only the vowels that are within double quotes. So let us match our double quoted data. In the replacement, we'll call the substitute function. So for the substitute function, we need to provide what is the input we are working on. So we can use the submatch function again and we'll pass the entire captured portion. And our search pattern is vowel characters. In replacement, we just want to uppercase the matched characters and we want to change all the vowel characters, so we'll use the G flag. So essentially we are performing a substitute operation on the matched portion. So these vowel characters should get uppercased. And you can see this is not affected because this is not part of double quotes. For more details, you can go through the help topic substitute function, because there are some subtle differences when compared to this substitute command. And finally, let's see an example with perl. So let's go back to this earlier example where we want to multiply the numbers by 2. So if your Vim installation supports perl, so then you can call the substitute operator from perl. So we'll match the digits. Note that plus will not require a escape sequence because this is Perl based regular expression, not vim. And in replacement, we'll use $ to represent the entire matched portion, multiply by 2. Since we have multiple numbers, we are using G flag, and the E flag allows us to use Perl code in replacement section. So these numbers should get multiplied by 2, and that's what we get. You will also note that I used dot as the range because, unlike S, the default range is $1, that is the entire file contents. You can go through the help topic Perl do for more details. The functions which we saw, like submatch, strftime, eval, etc. So you can find details about that in user_41.txt help topic. So that is the Vim script chapter. And for more details about \= you can go through the help topic sub-replace-expression.